Yeah. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Okay, bye. Good morning and welcome to St. John's Cathedral on this, the first Sunday in June here in Brisbane. It's the first Sunday in what we would call winter. My name is Blair Martin. I'm a member of St. John's Cathedral worshipping community and a member of our Labyrinth Circle. Before I commence today's Labyrinth Walk and time of meditation together, I acknowledge our traditional owners and custodians of the land and where I am today, the Turrbal and Yagara people of the Yugara Nation. I acknowledge their elders, past, present, and future. I acknowledge that the land and the waters of and around this land are theirs. Sovereignty was never ceded by any means of treaty or fair and honest and just means. It is, was, and always will be their land. And in the dialect of the Yugara people, I say, Wonya, welcome. Our guided labyrinth walks happen on the first Sunday of the month, following our 9:30 Eucharist, commencing around 11:15 or thereabouts, but you may be watching this after the event. All our guided labyrinth walks are available on our YouTube channel. Following the time that we had with the COVID-19 pandemic, we have been recording our labyrinth walks. Now that we are able to walk again in person, we are doing them live. Today, though, I don't appear to have anyone with me, but that's fine. I know you are with me here in spirit. So, if you've never walked or followed a labyrinth before, that's fine. There is no right or wrong way to walk and follow a labyrinth. The labyrinth that we have here at St. John's Cathedral is a Chartres-style labyrinth based on the great medieval labyrinth in Chartres Cathedral, France. The Chartres Cathedral is a 13-circuit labyrinth. This one is a 7-circuit. The design of the labyrinth was created by Australian artist and labyrinth practitioner Seda Prest, who was located in South Australia. If you are walking or following the labyrinth, you can walk or follow it however you wish. If you just wish to go straight to the center and have a time of quiet contemplation, that's fine. Or, as I will be doing shortly, following the path in and out. Our labyrinth walk for today. This is the first Sunday in the season of Trinity, or the second Sunday after Pentecost, depending on the method of counting you are following. Our theme today is love. As we now journey throughout the rest of the year, this is the longest season of the church year, the Sundays following Pentecost and Trinity. So what is able to allow us to go on that long journey together? Love. So our focus of our readings and our meditation today is on love. During my time of walking the labyrinth, you will hear music written by the late Sir John Taverner called The Bridegroom, based on Eastern Orthodox part of their liturgy and sung by Anonymous Four, and also featuring the strings of the Chilagirian Quartet. And so, if you are joining me online, you will have found that there is a link to our cathedral website where those walking notes are available. And there's also an opportunity to download a finger labyrinth as well to follow. We thank you for being with us today. So let us open the labyrinth together. And if you would say these words from 1 Corinthians chapter 12 with me. Love is patient. Love is kind. Love is not envious or boastful or arrogant or rude. It bears all things, believes all things, hopes all things, endures all things. Love never ends. Our text to prepare us for our walk on the labyrinth is from Micah, the prophet Micah, which many people take this portion from chapter 6, verses 6 to 8, as their own personal mantra for living life. With what shall I come before the Lord and bow myself before God on high? Shall I come before him with burnt offerings, with calves a year old? Will the Lord be pleased with thousands of rams, with tens of thousands of rivers of oil? Shall I give my firstborn for my transgression, the fruit of my body for the sin of my soul? He has told you, O mortal, what is good. And what does the Lord require of you? But to do justice, to love kindness, to walk humbly with your God. We're going to say a passage now to commence our time of the walk and meditation from the Song of Songs, another book of the Old Testament. Some call it the Song of Solomon. So as you prepare to walk the labyrinth, take with you those things that trouble you, things that you would like answers for. Take them into the center. Spend time there, leave them there, and then on the way out, come out freeing from the burdens that came in with you. You may not get an answer straight away, but the beauty of the labyrinth is that it allows you to contemplate, to follow the one singular path that winds into the center, back out again, focusing on love. So let us say these verses from the third chapter of the Song of Songs. I will rise now, go about the city, the streets, and in the squares. I will seek him whom my soul loves. I sought him, but found him not. The sentinels found me as they went about in the city. Have you seen him whom my soul loves? Thank you. God abides in them. Love has been perfected among us in this, that we may have boldness on the day of judgment, because as he is, so are we in this world. There is no fear in love. Perfect love casts out fear. For fear has to do with punishment, and whoever fears has not reached perfection in love. We love because God first loved us. If you would say the blessing with me, following the words in bold type, with this blessing prayer. From the fear that holds me rigid, God of gentleness, ease me forward. From the fear of surrender, God of warmth, melt the ice around my heart. From my fear of making decisions, God of power, release me. In my fear of losing respect, God of courage, steady. From the fear of losing my fear, God of laughter, loosen me. But in the fear that marks your presence, God of love, keep me in awe and wonder. For the grace, we have the prayer of St. Columba of Iona. This prayer is excellent for using a technique known as praying the body. For those of you that have followed these labyrinth walks, both live and online, you will know that there has been times when I've used this and I've demonstrated praying the body too. If you are following these notes, you will see that there are notes on what actions to do with each part of the prayer. Praying the body is an ancient religious technique. It can be found in all traditions and is certainly part of our Christian faith. So, I'll demonstrate how we are to pray the body. We start with our hands in prayer position, in front of our heart. We say, my dearest Lord. We then move our prayer hands to our forehead. My dearest Lord, be thou a bright flame before me. We then move our hands up to the sky. Be thou a bright star above me. We move our hands out to the side, the arms stretched. Be thou a smooth path beneath me. And then, holding ourselves as if in the embrace of God, be thou a kindly shepherd behind me. And returning to the beginning, this day and forevermore. Amen. So, let us now do this together. For the grace, the prayer of St. Columba of Iona. My dearest Lord, be thou a bright flame before me. Be thou a guiding star above me. Be thou a smooth path beneath me. Be thou a kindly shepherd behind me. This day and forevermore. Amen. Thank you for joining me. Whether you've joined live online here on Sunday, the 6th day of June, or at another time. We do walk our labyrinths in person on the first Sunday of each month. Our next labyrinth walk in person here under the rose window in the northern transept of St. John's Cathedral, Brisbane, will be on Sunday, the 4th day of July. I won't be here that day. I have another prior commitment. However, there will be a live labyrinth walk. I'm told the Dean will be leading it. I look forward to making your acquaintance again the next time that we are together. Until then.